Breaking just now, Senate Republicans have announced a hearing next week on the state of commercial aviation safety. This comes as we're learning very disturbing new details about what happened aboard one of the two Boeing airliners that crashed recently. Both crashes killed everyone on board. Let's get the latest from CNN's Tom Foreman. Tell us more about these late developments.
Well, Wolf, tonight they're moving much more quickly toward these hearings simply because we're being hit with a torrent of stories that seem every day more astonishing.
For 9 terrifying minutes, the cockpit recorder captures a crew fighting to pull up a plane that is repeatedly diving toward the sea, scouring the operations manual for any explanation, apparently unaware they are battling an onboard computer that is forcing those dives. This is what Reuters is reporting tonight from sources familiar with the Lion Air crash off Indonesia last fall. Reuters says the crew seemed oblivious to the fact the tail was automatically tilting. They didn't seem to know the trim was moving down. They thought only about airspeed and altitude. In the final moments, Reuters says one pilot issued a short prayer before the crash killed all 189 people aboard. Boeing and Indonesian authorities are not commenting, but analysts say the training was insufficient.
Well, it must have been just horrifying in the cockpit for these professionals. I mean, it's been stated, well, it should have been a memory item. Well, clearly it wasn't.
What's more, Bloomberg reports that same Lion Air jet had the same problem one day before and was saved because an off-duty pilot in the cockpit told the crew to cut power to that automatic system. Still, the plane took off again.
This is what I call the fly it and watch it kind of attitude, but that should not have occurred here. This was replicatable, and I can't understand why at least it wasn't test flown or brought out on the ramp and tested again.
It all raises troubling questions about the fatal Ethiopian jet crash, which authorities say looks a lot like the Lion Air disaster. Why did Boeing design that anti-stall software to rely on only one sensor? Why were pilots not given more pointed warnings and more extensive training? And where was the Federal Aviation Administration?
What happens, in fact, is that the measures taken by Boeing after the first accident were not enough to avoid the second accident.
Boeing says it is fixing the problem.
Soon, we'll release a software update for the 737 MAX that will address concerns discovered in the aftermath of the Lion Air Flight 610 accident.
But Lion Air went down almost 5 months ago.
In defense of Boeing, some analysts point out that these 737 MAX jets have taken off and landed safely tens of thousands of times since the Lion Air crash. But authorities worldwide are saying that is simply not enough. Boeing must now prove the planes are fully safe before any will be allowed to take passengers and fly again.
Yeah, let's not forget 346 people. 346 people, men, women, and children, were killed in those two crashes involving that aircraft. All right, thanks very much, Tom Foreman.